Hello there, this is Harmony, and we're here on our urban homestead in our greenhouse. I'm gonna want to give you guys a little greenhouse update. So, the greenhouse is pretty much completed. We're gonna put a little bit of corrugated plexi up there in the corner. And we have lots of abundance and growing. The vegetation is happening, and the plants look like they're happy. This is our bed of cucumbers, and there's a squash and some bell peppers, so a couple spicy peppers, and some basil interplanted. There's also couple more cucumbers from India here and a tomato. We have a net against the wall here. It'd be a nice trellis for these cucumbers to grow up on. These are some nice cucumbers growing up here. And some Thai basil as well. A lot of companion planting going on. The companion planting helps the it's like beneficial for the plants and the insects. It brings in the beneficial insects and repels any unwanted pests and insects. Helps to increase essential oil production and flavor in the food as well. So we also have a avocado tree that we grew from seed here, and as you can see, it's pretty large now. It's going to be very happy in here. We're going to be putting that in a bed in the corner behind me. We also have this long bed here is full of tomatoes, beans, eggplants, kohlrabi, and basil. And as you can see, we have four bamboo rods coming up where the tomatoes are. And in between here, we have a set of eggplants. I don't know if you can see this on the camera, but they have spikes and thorns right in the center of the leaf on the stem. It's really quite cool. I've never seen eggplants like that before. And in between this set of tomatoes is some bush beans with little baby beans on them and lots of flowers doing wonderful bloom time. And some more eggplant down here. And some more bush beans. Right behind there is a longevity spinach. Got a little shocked down during the transplant, but it's starting to revive itself. And we are working on the floor right now. We've laid down the sand, and now we're leveling out where we want the rows of pavers, and we're putting in spacers so we can space out evenly our pavers. Then over here in this corner, we're going to have another raised bed, and this is where we'll plant our banana tree that's in the house and our avocado tree, this date palm here, and pineapple that we grew from the top of a pineapple. And we have some turmeric back here that the old leaves aren't looking so great, but it has new spikes all over in the dirt. We put in a shelf up here, and it was a nice shelf we got for free. It says trash, and I get a magic eraser and clean that up. But it's a great place to store things, and we will eventually probably put a small little wash basin sink right here as well underneath. And then right here we have a tub full of corn. It's a beautiful organic Hopi blue corn. And I found that this is a really nice way to grow corn because you can move it around if it needs more sun or more pollination, and you can line up a few different tubs, and you can start it in your greenhouse and then move it out. And we already have a bunch of little baby starts coming through the soil. Very exciting. So So as you can see, we have sand underneath the floor, and underneath this flooring is also some tubing to bring radiant heat underneath the floor in the wintertime. I hope you enjoyed this update of our Urban Homestead greenhouse. As you can see, this isn't very large, but I have a lot of food in here, a lot of food production. And in the winter, I'll be putting a lot of my herbs that don't weather over very well in the Pacific Northwest. And I'll be growing some greens and some other things that grow in a little cooler weather. But we'll also be able to grow some other warmer things because we'll have the radiant heat. And, oh, also here is our white sacred sage. I'm very excited. Anyhow, subscribe, like, and stay tuned for the next video of organic gardening on our urban homestead.